Gotta be honest with you, when I see a punk armed robber get his butt whooped, it makes me happy. Hi everyone, welcome to today's lesson here at Active Self-Protection. I'm your host, as always, John Correa. Today's video comes to us from El Salvador.
This is not a paid endorsement, but I am a brand ambassador for Heckler & Koch for a reason. HK firearms are incredibly high quality, and when it's time to step up out of the entry tier, they're the only ones I recommend. You carry a gun just in case. Shouldn't it be an HK just in case?
Barber's giving this guy a haircut. It's a normal day until this guy walks in, draws a firearm, chambers it, announces a robbery, and then starts shaking everybody down. You can see him just has the gun down at his side there. It's gonna click forward in just a second. That's them, not me. So he's gonna actually whack that guy on the head with the gun and then tell him what's up and say, hey man, I want your wallet. And the guy says, hey, my wallet is actually in my backpack. So our guy's gonna go grab his backpack. Okay, man, here's my wallet, whatever. Now, when he goes to get it, our barber sees the fact that he's got his gun hanging down and grabs for it and takes it away from him and boops him on the snoot with it right there. And now they're gonna start kicking the guy. It's gonna become a family hoedown here. They give him a few good kicks, and now a guy's gonna come from the back and realize, oh, okay, well, we're gonna all get involved in this. They kicked the snot out of this guy and then held him for the cops. He's facing charges, and let's learn some lessons.
Well, that one is gonna give us some lessons, but good job to those guys. If you wanna see me in person, did you know that one of the ways you can do that is by joining us at the big events in the US? I'm gonna be speaking at the NRA annual meetings. I usually go to the USCCA Expo. We go to SHOT Show, all those places. So hit the link to my website and find on the calendar there where we'll be in when, and do me a favor, come say hi, let's take a selfie.
So again, a normal day at this barbershop, and they have experienced robberies in the past, according to the news story that I've linked in the description. So especially when you have been victimized in the past, you have to be ready and understand what your priorities are. And of course, in these kinds of priorities, guy is gonna draw a gun from concealment. You don't get an opportunity to ambush him right at that moment. If you try to draw a gun on a guy that's got a drawn gun, you're drawing from the drop, you're gonna be in a bad spot. So purposeful compliance is definitely the way here. Preparedness is the way. Would I rather these guys have firearms of their own? Absolutely I would. But in lacking that, having the awareness, the attitude, the skills, the plan in order to do well for yourself is good. Now, I do want you to notice that how just casually he has a hold of the gun here. You can see he's just kind of got it dangling at his side. He's actually not pointing it at people. He's not gripping it firmly. So if you're paying attention, these kinds of things in an armed robbery can give you clues as to your best strategy. Do I just give the guy my stuff? Do I go to work on this guy? How am I gonna handle this? So seeing little details like that can really help you, which is why we say pay attention even in the midst of a robbery, because if you do, you might find your opportunity to counter ambush just like this barber did. Now then, our guy comes over and he hits this guy in the head who's a customer. And we say this on the channel and we see it pretty regularly. Somebody who will hit you with a firearm so they will use it as a bludgeoning tool seldom is willing to use it as a ballistic tool, as a deadly force implement. Now, I will tell you that it's still aggravated assault. You hit somebody in the head with a gun, you're likely to put them in the hospital, but it should help us as defenders. Now, it's not a lock solid thing. It's not 100%, but usually if they'll hit you with the gun, they probably won't shoot you with the gun. So that gives you some more options and lets you know kind of what's to come and what you ought to do. Whether that's comply or find a time to resist is up to you in your situation in the moment. So he's gonna say, hey, I want your wallet. Okay, man, let me get you my wallet, that's fine. Let's think about the barber here who's kind of standing here and just going, oh, okay, man, or I think he might be on his knees there or something. I don't think his knees. I think he's just standing there in a weird spot. So then he sees that he has an opportunity. Our robber has his back to him. He has the gun loosely held, so he decides to go and take the gun away from him. Now you gotta practice those 5 D's plus 1. Of course, if he had his own firearm, he'd just go to work on his own firearm. But those 5 D's plus 1, we cover the distance, then we deflect, dominate, distract, disarm, disable. So our barber covers the distance and then gets in there and gun's already deflected away from him. It's not pointing at him. So now he's gonna dominate the gun and the hand with the gun, arm with the gun if you can, then the whole person with the gun. Then what we've got to do is we've got to start distracting, because what's gonna happen here pretty quick is he's gonna fight. So when we do these things, you see these on the mat sometimes against non-resisting opposition, these disarms look really easy. In real life, you have resisting opposition, he doesn't want you to take the gun away, then what's gonna happen is exactly what happens here. The guy grabs the gun harder and tries to pull it away. And of course, he's holding the gun by the handle, the holdy-ony part, and you have a hold of the gun by the slide, the shooty part, and so he's gonna have a significant advantage there. which is why one of the things we say is to distract. And the way that we distract, we break things on him, we inflict injury on him, we upset his balance, his posture, that will tend to do that. And it's exactly what we see here. That distract was upsetting his posture, knocking him on the ground, made him not think about the gun, which let him then disarm. And once we disarm, now we say it's time to, you know, to disable. When we say disable, we don't mean put him in a high, you know, in a wheelchair or something like that. What we mean by that is we remove his ability to harm us. Now, of course, our barber here booped him right on the snoot. I don't have any problems with that. At some point, you gotta recognize once the guy gives up that you gotta stop, okay? But he's gonna take himself a little bit of a beating here. Guy's got his fire. I'm gonna whack him in the noodle again. And now the kicking begins. So they're gonna treat this guy like a pinata. I will say during that, watch what happens here with the barber is that he swung the gun around and pointed it at his buddy while he's trying to kick this guy. As a good, sane, sober, moral, prudent person, you have to practice the rules of safe firearms handling. You have to make sure that that firearm is always pointed in the direction of least consequence, and your buddy is not the direction of least consequence. Instead, make sure you unload that gun if you're not gonna use it, drop the magazine, unchamber the gun, get it out of the fight for the time being, and always keep it pointed in the direction of least consequence and your finger high and in register if you don't intend to fire it. So now guys come out, okay, fine. They're gonna just absolutely go after this guy. And you know what? These kind of educational beatdowns in many places in the world are the only form of policing that a community has. Totally okay with that in those kind of places. Eventually, again, as good, sane, sober, moral, prudent people, we have to stop. And they did stop, held this guy for the cops who when he's facing charges. So good job on this barber. Let's learn the lessons here about purposeful compliance, about looking for our turn, about practicing the 5 D's plus one as we cover our ASP.